This is the YGTV News with Georgina White.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Friday the 28th of September. I'm Georgina White. Opposition welcomes UK's UN statement on Gibraltar sovereignty. Mayor hosts reception for small business owners. Macmillan coffee morning held in Gibraltar. Gibtelecom apprentices graduate. And finally, Dr. Cortes visits St. John's Ambulance. The GSD today welcomed the statement made by the UK to the UN in retaliation to Spanish Prime Minister Mariano Rajoy's urge to return to the Brussels process. Prime Minister David Cameron reaffirmed in the clearest possible terms to the UN the commitment by the United Kingdom not to enter into any process of talks with which the people of Gibraltar are not content. Commenting on the issue, Daniel Feetham noted that the party was pleased with the fact that the United Kingdom has reasserted before the United Nations. A reception for a broad spectrum of Gibraltar small business owners was held yesterday evening at the Mayor's Parlour. As part of his inception speech, His Worship the Mayor noted that it was his aim to invite as many people to the City Hall as possible, most notably those who have never been invited before. Speaking at the event, Minister with Responsibility for Small Businesses, Neil Costa, said that it is a fallacy for any politician to believe that it is the government that creates growth. He explained that it is in fact the businesses that create growth by providing job opportunities. This morning saw Gibraltar's version of the Macmillan Cancer Support, world's biggest coffee morning, a quintessential tea break aimed to help raise money and awareness for cancer. Your Gibraltar TV attended the event and spoke to organiser Sonia Fendley for more information.
Thank you very much for speaking to us today, Sonia. Could you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Well, my name is Sonia Fendley and I work for STM Numos. We are registered intermediaries for Bupa International, acting as local agents to help their members in Gibraltar and also in Spain. Basically, the point of today, I saw that Macmillan in the UK, which is a registered cancer charity, were hosting the world's biggest coffee morning. And because Lady Williams Cancer Care here is a registered Macmillan charity, I thought it would be a fantastic opportunity to raise some money and raise awareness here as well. And so we're hosting a coffee morning here, which has been fantastic because the weather has not kept people from coming. We're raising lots of money. We're having coffee, which has been donated by Anglo Hispano. We are having cakes donated by friends and family. Everyone's been baking and taking part, and we're just having a really, really good response. We will be having a raffle shortly. We've had a donation of a breast scan, a lymphatic scan by Body Works Clinic in Estepona, and also a full body scan by Radwan in Sotogrande, which is priced at over €1,000. So we've had really, really good sponsors. And we just thank everybody, really, for turning up and for not making this a washout with the awful weather that we had this morning. Really, really appreciated. Fantastic support from Gibraltar, as I expected.
Well, thank you very much. Thankfully, it's a perfect morning for tea and coffee.
Yesterday evening, a graduation ceremony was held for Gibtelecom's communications apprentices. The programme, launched in 2008, saw 8 participants carry out a 4-year scheme that included completing a Level 3 BTEC in professional competence for IT and telecom professionals. Commenting on the event, Chairman of Gibtelecom, Deputy Chief Minister Dr. Garcia noted that the initiative is creating real opportunities for young people with skills to serve the ever-growing communications needs of the company together with the local economy. Those qualifying from the programme have all been offered employment contracts with the company following their graduation. And finally, Health Minister Dr. Cortes visited the St. John's Ambulance Association recently to be updated on the services which the association provides to the GHA and to the community in general. The association's chairman and its commander told Dr. Cortes about the procedure by which the GHA asked the St. John's to transfer provided patients to and from Spain and, on other occasions, to transport urgent supplies of blood. That's the YGTV News. I'm back on Monday. Have a great weekend.